standing to welcome the Woodfarm High School graduates 2015.
Thank you. staff, families, friends and honoured graduates of the class of 2015. Welcome to Woodfarm High School's graduation ceremony. Thank you all for joining us this evening, and thank you also for providing the support, motivation and guidance that has fostered the success of these fine young adults sitting in front of us this evening. This, as you know, is the first time I've had the pleasure of speaking in front of a graduating class as Woodfarm's head teacher. So this evening is very special for me. I too am just as nervous as you. When I was in high school, albeit many years ago, I had the unfortunate habit of tripping upstairs at prize-giving ceremonies. I hope that none of you share that trait with me tonight. I would like to welcome back, sitting right in front of me here, looking very relaxed, our former head teacher, Anne Stewart. Anne will certainly share, and I'm sure agree, with my thoughts and words throughout this speech. 6 years ago, most of you joined Woodfarm as a group of anxious young S1s, excited and scared as you entered the big world of high school. Here you are today, sitting in the street area for one last time, now as a graduating class of 2015. Hopefully, you're feeling a lot less anxious, although I imagine you're as equally as excited and scared about entering the big, real world that faces you. You have made it together. You have focused on making Woodfarm a school that you can take pride in. You've made Woodfarm a school where you could achieve your personal best. As I reflected on your experiences in anticipation of this day, I thought a lot about what I would say to you here this evening at your graduation ceremony. One memory really struck me, and it happened only a few weeks ago. On the stairs, just at the entrance to this street area, you sat as a year group on Leavers Day, and every single one of you cheered with enthusiasm and delight when we took your last picture here together as a whole year group. You were a team, a successful team, and you will be a very hard act to follow for next year's class of 2016. On Leavers Day, you also applauded your head boy and head girl without prompting when they came to sit with you on the stairs. This shows a natural warmth, a gratitude, a respect and admiration for two young adults who have served not only all of you, but our whole school so well throughout this last year. Sophie and Grant, I thank you both for making my time at Woodfarm so far enjoyable, entertaining and enlightening. You have represented Woodfarm on many occasions, some of which have been quite difficult and challenging for you, but your strength of character and ability to adapt to any circumstances has been commendable. You have given me the support and dedication that other head teachers can only dream of. You have given your fellow graduates a truly exceptional experience for their last year at school, as you've used your charms and talents and dedication to win over Mrs. Mooney and myself to agree to allowing various events to take place throughout S6. Well done to you both. You are a credit to Woodfarm and to your families. 2015, you are a class that I will never forget. It's at this point in my speech that I'm going to take you back a few months to another photographic experience that the school provided for you. And again, it involves the persuasion of Mrs. Mooney, a common theme throughout your final year. It was early September. You were all standing in the Assembly Hall getting your S6 yearbook photograph taken. That's when I got true measure of your personalities and your strengths of character. Well, it was the strength of one of your characters anyway. At the final photograph of that morning, you were allowed to take off your blazers and your ties, something that didn't sit well with me because it's not dressing for excellence. You're allowed to stand next to your friends in a very casual manner. And that's when one of you approached me and said, and I am quoting verbatim, "Miss, how do you think it would be if I was to approach Mrs. Mooney and ask her to lie down on the floor across the front of us in a cool way for this picture?" Well, at that point, I added bravery to your list of personal qualities. My diplomatic response to Amir was, "Well, Amir, I'm not entirely sure that would be the best thing for you to do, but who am I to stop you from asking?" I stood back and enjoyed watching Mrs. Mooney graciously decline Amir's offer. From that moment on, I knew it was going to be a year filled with many interesting moments. Confident individuals, you most definitely are. You are not only all very special individuals, we are also good friends to each other. During these past 6 years, we have shared very personal, and in some cases, life-changing experiences as a cohesive peer group. I believe these experiences have helped to make you the determined and passionate young adults you are today. Some opportunities have had an enormous impact on you. Opportunities such as the World Challenge, which gave you the leadership qualities that you need to become effective contributors in society today. Gabriel and Lisa's trip to Auschwitz and the impact this has had not only on you both, but on the whole school when you shared your humbling experiences at Assemblies. Our Amnesty International group and their contributions at our Making Sense Up events, sharing the global issues of human rights, has also left our younger pupils with a drive to make a difference for people who are less fortunate than ourselves. The contributions from all of the various S6 committees have been commendable. To the Charities Committee, a series of events have ensured that you have raised over £1,000 for various charities, like Cause for Care, Children in Need, Comic Relief, and Macmillan Cancer Care. Well done to you all. To the Yearbook Committee, thank you for the work that went on behind the scenes to ensure that your yearbook was one appropriate and fit for teenage consumption. And two, one of the best and most fitting memories of your time here at Woodfarm High School. To the Prom Committee, the Leaders Day Committee, and the Events Committee, well done for ensuring that this final year has been full of excellent opportunities for you all to share. Our final committee is the Isabel Mayer Committee. And you only have to look at Michael and Fraser sitting here tonight, part of this yearbook celebration, to see that you have welcomed and embraced our young people from Isabel Mayer into the Woodfarm spirit of teamwork, inclusion and achievement. I know that the friendships that have evolved over this year between our two schools will only continue to grow. To our sports ambassadors and our language ambassadors, your leadership roles and presentations at both our own school assemblies and at our cluster primary schools has ensured that younger people understand Woodfarm is a place to flourish through active participation both in class and at after school clubs. To the house captains, I thank you for taking your leadership roles seriously and for promoting the house system as a way of the whole school recognising the wider achievements of our pupils and ensuring that we give credit to the many successes that all of our young people have enjoyed. You have empowered our junior house captains to take on this very important role now that you have left. I would also like to thank you for making sure that the staff didn't cheat when it came to the house points. I thought that Mr. Giles and Mr. McCacken were competitive, that PE streak to win at everything. It's not about the taking part, it's about the winning. But then I saw Mrs. Strain and Miss Vouch in action, and realised that they were a force to be reckoned with. Well done to Bute House for winning the House Cup this year. To our senior prefect group, a warm thank you for working so well together, supporting not only your head boy and head girl, but the whole school family, to ensure that we have been excellent in everything that we have done. Your mix of leadership styles have allowed you to experience success in everything that you have tackled this year. Woodfarm High School is now a place where attainment and achievement are recognised and celebrated, and you have all played an important part in this. I hope that we as a school have been able to teach each of you to achieve your goals, and that we've helped you to make it through the difficult times that come with growing up, and that in some way we have helped you to celebrate and appreciate your successes so far in life. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the staff at Woodfarm High School for their contribution to the successes of the young adults in front of us tonight, and for giving them the best and most holistic educational experience you could ever have had. Class of 2015, you can leave here tonight knowing that you have left your mark. Believe in yourself. Don't let your fears of the unknown stop you from taking on new challenges. As Thomas Edison once said, our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. I know you will keep on trying. I know that you will achieve excellence in everything you do through hard work, self-belief, determination and passion. Class of 2015, congratulations and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you. Thank you. I'm now going to hand over to Mr. Stewart, who will start the graduation process. Thank you.
Okay, but we'll make a start with our first graduate of the evening. So I'd like to welcome onto the stage tonight, Sophie Gibson. Then, Kate Lafferty. Emma Irvin. Finally, Nicole Barrett. Stewart. Gabriel Backcombe. And last of this group of three, Grant Beaton. Amy Smith. Megan Mitchell. Zayn Ahmed. And Andrea Athey. Emily Anderson. Siobhan Archibald. Una Miller. And Lisa Cordy. Ewan Kyle. David McCallum. Craig Nicholson. And Sean McGinty. Visit Azar. Kate Beattie. Harriet Beattie. And Zen Cameron. Fiona Boyd. Jack Cahill. Habiba Chowdhury. And Nicola Davies. Erin Yunus. Faisal Amjit. Arman Neem. Finally, Tohid Nadim. Hamza Akbar. Ayub Azim. Azam, sorry. Ayub Azam. Max Belshaw. Lois Boyd. Emily Caldwell. Heather Carrick. Stuart Clarkson. And Darren Law. Jack Corsi. Rhys Critch. Mohamed Amin. And Chelsea Cooley. Amy Edgar. And Peter Gallagher. Rachel Hogarth. Lucy Irwin. And Caitlin Jones. Amir Khan. Joy Kinnear. And last of this group of three, Nishat Fayyad. Sandy Fleming. Sam Findlay. Callum Grindley. Sarah Hamid. Scott Hasty. Adam Lamy. Hannah Lumley. And Rory Mackay.
James Onions. Zaki Ali. Simran Kaur. And Rosie Cover. Ruth Mackey. Jack McCowan. Andrew McCready. And Courtney McFadden. Anissa Mugo. Simon Beck. Cara Payton. And David Plant. Kevin Thirumanayagam. Equally challenging, Charlie Wallace. Emma Ward. And Sophie Wilson. Martin Wiseman. Rogan Stewart. Ryan Jones. And there's two more to cover in this group. David Webster. And Faisal Namud. Another group of five now. Catherine Watt. Peter Williams. Emily Middlemas. Gavin Ford. And Karen Corr. Mrs. McGlashan alluded in her speech that this is our first year of our joint campus with Isabel Mayer School senior pupils in the Yale group, and we're delighted to have two of our pupils from Isabel Mayer School graduating with us this evening. So first of many future graduations we're looking forward to. So we'd like to welcome Michael DiPaolo. So that concludes the graduation ceremony. So congratulations now to our graduates who have passed through that ceremony and are officially graduates of Woodfarm High School. I'm sure that now you'll be looking forward to hearing not from the staff, but from one of your very own. Each year we have our valedictory address, and this year I'd like to welcome to the front our valedictorian, Nicholas Stewart.
Parents and guardians, teachers and staff, distinguished guests and fellow graduates, it is my honour to welcome you all to Woodfarm High School this evening, to the graduation ceremony that marks the end of a memorable and unforgettable 6 years for the class of 2015. First of all, I want to say how extremely grateful I am to have been chosen as this year's valedictorian. When Mrs. Mooney first told me that I would be making a speech as the representative of our entire year group, I was more than a little overwhelmed. Everyone I spoke to for advice reminded me of the gravitas of the valedictorian task. And they reminded me of it in a way that left me fearing I would only be able to bring the ass of the gravitas. Our years at Woodfarm have flown by even faster than we could have imagined. The class of 2015 has contributed immeasurably to the growth and success of the school over the past 6 years. And I'm sure we can all leave knowing that in some way we each had a positive impact on the future of Woodfarm. I'm also sure that many of you, like me, have spent the last year counting down to this day, when we finally make the transition from school life to real life, free from school bells, school lunches, and school homework. But I know I speak for all of us when I say that now it is here, I feel some sadness. Sadness at leaving behind many of the people who have been integral parts of our lives and who have helped shape us into the young and, let's face it, awesome adults we are today. And sadness at knowing that this might be the last time we're together as a hopeful, enthusiastic, supportive group. Although you may think that tonight is only about us, it is not. Tonight, three members of staff will also leave Woodfarm for the last time. Mrs. Miller, who has been a key member of the Home Economics Department for many years, will be retiring this year. During her time at Woodfarm, she has been devoted to her department and to the school as a whole. With her departure, pupils will no longer have to frantically find a tub for the period before home ec after realising they've left theirs at home. And after receiving my one and only punishment exercise in my 6 years here from Mrs. Miller, I can confirm that talking during her lesson is not advisable. Another retiree is our head of the Support for Learning, Mrs. Chalmers. According to Mrs. Stake, Mrs. Chalmers joined Woodfarm as a network support teacher a long time ago. Without any doubt, the two aspects of Mrs. Chalmers' character that are best known are the huge amount of additional support she has given to the most vulnerable pupils and her love of golf. After all the work she has done here, her day is now being spent enjoying a glass of Prosecco before teeing off are well deserved. Our final leaver, Mrs. Nielsen, has been one of Woodfarm's most dedicated staff members for a few years, 38 years to be exact. She has always been more than happy to give up her time to help pupils with their physics and also to assist at school events. Let's be honest, nothing signified the last day of term better than some of her signature Mars bar cake. It and she will undoubtedly be sorely missed by staff and pupils alike. I would also like to take this time to mention the sad passing of Miss Graham. A teacher who had a deep passion for her subject, Miss Graham had an ability to inspire pupils to pursue their dreams. She was a character within the tapestry of Woodfarm who will not soon be forgotten. As valedictorian, it is my role to thank the people who have supported and encouraged us over the last 6 years. Certainly, the advice of some of these people will never be forgotten, including a lesson from Mr. McDonald's fake ID experience. If you're going to take the risk of using one, make sure it doesn't misspell the word college. Firstly, to Mrs. W and Nicola in the community wing. Throughout S6, you have served as our crisps and our cans and our pot noodles, and you've done it all with smiles on your faces. We know you will miss watching the pool table being hustled like it was sponsored by Ladbrokes. I doubt any graduate in front of me tonight hasn't owed special money at some point. The community wing was our status symbol, our sanctuary and our safe haven. Thank you both for helping it run so smoothly. Thank you to the cleaners and to the janitors in the school, who always worked hard to provide a welcoming and purposeful environment to learn in. Thank you to all of our teachers and pupil support staff who put in an enormous amount of effort and time to ensure we all had the best chance at success. Although we rarely said it, we really did appreciate you and everything you did for us. Indeed, without Mr. O'Toole's in-depth knowledge of the SQA, without Mrs. Mooney's ability to see into our very souls with just one withering glance, or without Mrs. Eyre's enforcement of a one-way traffic system, our time at Woodfarm would have been considerably less fun. And my final thanks goes to all of you, my fellow graduates, not just for voting me to be your valedictorian, but also for being such a fantastic group of people to spend the last 6 years of my life with. I'd now like to do what everyone does in an inspirational speech and attempt to depict what famous, or indeed infamous, icons some of our classmates will become. Craig Nicholson to be the next Wayne Rooney. Gabriel Batcock to be the next Albert Einstein. Jennifer Sword to be the next Annie Leibovitz. And of course, Toheed. Toheed with his all-white outfits, trademark snapback and his lovely good lyric will surely be the next Chris Brown. What will our lasting memories of our time at Woodfarm be? Perhaps the co-hooks we all made in S2 Techie? Perhaps the Swiss rolls we all made in S2 Home Ec? Or perhaps the painful noises we all made in PE when we were cheerfully informed by Mr. McVeigh that it was yet again time for the blood test? Let's not pretend that we didn't all hate Rory and his ability to come first without even breaking a sweat. We have all had our fair share of stressful moments during our 6 years here, many of them happening during S6. Between meeting UCAS deadlines, running committees, and making that all-important decision about whether or not the dress was white and gold or blue and black. But absolutely no stress compared to having to confess your opinion about the Scottish independence referendum to either Max or Una. Just as important as what we will take away from our 6 years at school is what we're leaving behind. And I don't just mean the Sean-sized hole in the wall of the community line. I mean, what will the legacy of the class of 2015 be? As we prepare to leave through the doors of Woodfarm one final time, I believe we can take pride in what we've achieved here. The Charities Committee has worked tirelessly over the past year to raise money for extremely worthy local causes. We took part in a huge number of extracurricular activities with notable success in cross-country, netball, volleyball and tennis. I very much wish I could add football to this list, but with the senior team playing an entire season and picking up no points, I don't think I can. I should mention this was despite the best efforts of an ever optimistic Mr. McNally and an ever frustrated Dan Law. Another huge success for many people in our year group was the school musical Grease. The show brought together many departments from across the school and gave everyone a chance to work collaboratively to demonstrate their skills and talents. Being a part of the performance inspired many of the cast and crew to pursue a role in theatre outside of school, or in Nicole's case, just to continue living life one dramatic scene at a time. Despite there being really far too many successes to mention in this one speech, I would be remiss if I didn't highlight one of the great triumphs for us as a year group, and that is our ability and willingness to help others, as exemplified by the World Challenge trip to Sri Lanka. Many members of our year group made a real difference to people in need by helping to build a school, a project which not only changed the lives of those who will benefit from attending it, but also the lives of those who were privileged to be part of the Woodfarm World Challenge team. The school has experienced huge success with every trip we have been a part of, including the Duke of Edinburgh expeditions, the London music trip, and of course the PE department ski trips. We all remember a time when during one of these fantastic trips, Grant claimed he was pushed from moving ski lift. Obviously, we all believe that Grant merely fell. However, it should be noted that when Grant was rescued by the resort staff, there were some Rory-shaped handprints on the back of his jacket. Another adventure that was enjoyed by all was the S1 France trip, when lasting friendships were created and amazing memories were made. From the Hip Hotel's quality dining experience, to my ill-advised decision to wrap myself in a South African flag on the one day of the footballing year that their team were playing against France. I'd never known hostility like it, at least not until the time when Mrs. Mooney once saw the amount of litter left in the community wing. I'd like to thank Mrs. Strain and her team for their continued enthusiasm and for the hard work they put into organising and running the trip every year. We will definitely miss the endless showings of the France trip DVD each year in PSHE, but no doubt it will appear in social media at some point, just to immortalise Max's dancing at Disneyland, our impromptu sketch show, and to remind us all never to get into an argument with Simon Beck at the Eiffel Tower. The evening events hosted by the school have always been loved by both pupils and staff. From fundraising nights to the extraordinary PE Kayleys, some of the best nights of our lives were spent dancing around this street area. And I'm sure tonight at the prom will be no different. I'm also sure that the fashion will be on point, and I don't just mean the dapper Callum Finlay. Of course, some of our less than fashionable moments have already been captured in cringy Facebook albums for all to see, with super dry jackets and Jane Norman bags being the worst offending items. Although, we can probably all agree that absolutely no one now loves Paul Boutique. Much like Chad Hogan, house parties have been the main event on our social calendars throughout S5 and S6. We were forced to move indoors when we discovered that Val's Hill was no longer a suitable location for people of our maturity. Many of us will forever remember the unceremonious removal of a tired and emotional George from Gabriel's house. The unceremonious removal of my common sense when I decided kicking an American football inside David's house was a good idea. And the now infamous incident when a toilet was unceremoniously removed from a wall. With many of us jetting off to Zante in just a few days' time, ready to enjoy the renowned Greek culture and to sample as many of that renowned Greek dish, the kebab, as we can, it will surely be an educational experience. And if we're lucky, we might even get a tan to rival that of David Ross. During our time spent at Woodfarm, our year group has experienced significant change. From the change in uniform policy, which caused fashion chaos for the girls, as they could no longer wear their much-loved H&M tube skirts, to the long overdue renovation of the PE department, was brought to an end getting changed in the dark, cramped conditions. Although, regardless of any cosmetic changes in PE, one thing that will never change is the lightning speed at which pupils could get dressed after Mr. McVeigh announced, "If you're not ready in 1 minute, you'll be running." However, the main change for us has to be the multiple head teachers we've had during our time here. I mean, 3 in 6 years has to be some sort of record. Each of these inspirational people, Mr. Gibson, Mrs. Stewart, and Mrs. McGlashan, have encouraged us, guided us, and at times cajoled us into being the best versions of ourselves. I am confident that we will look back on our time at Woodfarm without regrets, perhaps even knowing that it will indeed forever be our glory days. Many of us have gained the qualifications necessary to begin the next stage of our lives, but all of us know that the time we have spent at Woodfarm has given us so much more than simply grades and an exam certificate. We have all formed friendships and created memories that will last a lifetime. And now, as we prepare to move on, whether it is to work, to university, or in Gabriel's case, to Peru, I wish you all the best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Okay, we now move into the part of the evening where we present specific awards, mostly to our senior pupils, but also to some of our other students who have gained specific awards through the year. And for each award, a member of staff or an honoured guest will come to the front to present the award. So we'll begin, first of all, with a very special award. For Office Angels. Now, Office Angels aren't quite the same as Charlie's Angels, those maybe some of them think they are. Office Angels are those pupils who have volunteered to help the office staff in their thankless task of helping to run the school. And this year, the awards are going to be presented by Mr. Ronnie Hillis. So I'll ask Ronnie to come to the front. And I think we've got quite a few Office Angels this year, so we'll ask them all to come up. Get the reward, and then we'll give them a big round of applause at the end. Okay, first of all, we welcome Kevin to the room and I again. Natalie Morgan, Ryan Potts, Heather Carrick, Jack Stevenson, Pizza Azar, and Siobhan Archibald. To do it because his mum needed him. Those of you who know Ryan's mum works in the office, so I think he had a good choice. I'm sure they were much more efficient when they were in the office. Mrs. McGlashan is now going to present a special gift for our head boy and head girl, and you will hear from her speech how much she valued them this year. So I'd like to welcome to the stage
Grant Beaton and Sophie Gibson. Our Director of Education, Mrs. Mary Shaw, to present the Charles Davis Cup for academic excellence, particularly in the arts subjects. And this year, the winner is Lisa Coldain. Mr. John Fitzpatrick, Head of Service, is going to present the John Anderson Quay for academic excellence, particularly in the sciences. Now, there's a little clue in one of our speeches about the winner of this one. It will go to Gabriel Backhorst. Crichton, Quality Improvement Officer, is going to present the Stenhouse Creek for excellence in art and design. The recipient this year is Amy Campbell. Teacher Mrs. Anne Stewart to come to present an award which she has inaugurated for the school. So this is the first year where we'll present the Anne Stewart Citizenship Award, if I can get it out, for a significant contribution to the wider school community, something which Anne certainly always valued as head teacher. So the first winner of this prestigious award is Una Miller. Now I'd like Miss Maureen Sneddon, Quality Improvement Officer, to present the Campbell Cup for excellence in music. And again, you might not be surprised to hear that the winner is Ewan Sinclair. Mrs. Audrey Miller, who we've heard is retiring as Teacher of Home Economics this year, is going to present the Ken Wiltshire Trophy for all-round excellence in the work for the school. And this year, again no surprise, the winner is Sophie Gibson. Principal Teacher of Support for Learning is going to come up and she's going to present the John Anderson Shield for progress and general excellence in the face of difficulty. This year the worthy winner of this award is Hamza Akbar. Michael will now come forward He's going to present the William Allen Memorial Prize for Excellence in Science in S4. The winner of this year's award goes to Noor Elaine Sakib. Councillor Jim Fletcher will present tonight the Duncan Anthony Award for Excellence in the Arts in S4. This year, the winner of this prize is Elaine Burgessie Stephen. Presented by Mrs. Anne Nielsen, a retiring teacher of physics, the Martin Sullivan Science Award is given for those who have demonstrated best practice in an advanced higher science project. This year, the winner is Zen Cameron. Invite to the stage Councillor Vincent Waters, who will present the Astrid Stirling Brown Sportswoman of the Year trophy. This year, our worthy winner is Harriet Beattie. Stirling Brown also donated the Sportsman of the Year trophy, and this is going to be presented by Councillor Gordon Wallace, who's not here tonight, so I'll ask our Director of Education, Mrs. Badger, if you wouldn't mind doing that again, obviously. We can call upon you again, alright, thank you. We'd like to welcome our winner of the Mrs. Astrid Stirling Brown Sportsman of the Year trophy, Christopher Stewart. Mrs. Von McColgan, head teacher of Thornleybank Primary School, is going to present the Players' Player of the Year trophy, which is one that's greatly valued in our team. And this year, the winner is Darren Law. The Margaret Gardner Award for Excellence in Dance tonight will be presented by Mrs. Pauline Ferguson, head teacher of Giffnock Primary School. And our award winner this evening is Gillian Kennedy. Will be presented tonight by Miss Catherine Devine, head teacher of Great Bar Primary School. And the winner is Nicholas Stewart. An annual, which is what is now an inter-house football tournament, which is very highly prized by our pupils, is the McRitchie Trophy, and we're delighted to welcome Mr. and Mrs. McRitchie here to present this award. So I'll call up the whole team and then we can give them a round of applause. Captain Darren Law, Ewan Kyle, David McCallum, Blair Murray, Craig Nicholson, Tori Nadine, Sean McGinty, Jack Lockett and Armin Naeem. That brings the presentation of the awards section to a close. Before we have a formal vote of thanks, we've got some more music to enjoy, and we're going to ask our graduation choir to come forward now to do a rendition of Thinking Out Loud and I'm Not the Only One, originally by Ed Sheeran and Sam Smith. Sheeran, see, I'm out of touch.
Oh,
thank you very much for that wonderful rendition. It's lovely to see our young people serenading themselves out of their wood farm time. We now move on to the final part of my section of this event, and that is to make some thanks to those who have made everything possible, and to share the thanks of this class of 2015 for this event. First of all, we would like to thank the school's office staff and the faculty management staff, the cleaners and janitors from East Renfrewshire Council and from BAM, who have worked so hard to get our event ready, both in preparing the materials and also preparing the venue. So thank you to all our support staff for that. And you're allowed to clap. Thank you. As ever, there are many other staff who work to make sure that the front of house and all the other staging, etc., are set up perfectly. So I'd like to thank Anne Nielsen, Sheila Anderson for her wonderful work with the flowers, Kevin Selby for all the sound and other front of house work that he's done, Adriana Luca, Paul Lindsay, Lorraine Strain, and John Kelly for all contributing the extra to this evening. Now, we do have some very talented young people in school, but to make the most of their talents, they really need some talented teachers to show them how. And I'd like to thank Ali Preston and William Morrow for their Beauty of the Year scholarship. And again, behind every great speaker, there's probably an army of helpers. And in this case, for our valedictorian, we have Miss Leanne Marshall, who worked very hard to support you. Also tonight, I thank our piper, David Gibson. Every year, we rely on our East Renfrewshire Council Directorate, our cluster heads, our invited guests to present our prizes, and obviously one impromptu one there for Mrs. Shaw. So thank you very much to all those who presented our prizes this evening. Thank you very much. We have three retirees for this term. We've heard about them. We'd like to thank them for also presenting this evening. One of maybe their final paid duties, hopefully. I'm sure they'll come back and do lots of volunteering once they've retired, as Mrs. Stewart has done. But we'll thank them now for offering those prizes. Thank you. The graduation and prom committee is one of the many committees within the school that the seniors have led so well this year. This year it was led by Grant and Sophie, and a big thank you to them again. Now, everyone in the senior management team obviously works hard to try and make sure that this event is a special one, but there's always one name missing from this list. That somebody, I think, deliberately forgets to put on, and that's Mrs. Mooney for organising this evening's event. So thank you so much. So you'll be perhaps glad or saddened to know that brings the formal part of this evening's proceedings really to a close. And the final gesture that we can make to our now graduates is, as they exit the hall, we'd ask you all to be upstanding to show your appreciation for this evening. Thank you very much.